Ah, yes. The color of love and blood and fire, but potentially love. Hello, everybody. Great Snowblaze. We're back with more of the game where vast amounts of money are made by putting houses back into their livable state after some schmuck came in and completely annihilated almost every single aspect of said dwelling. Over here in House Flipper, it's time to make that money. Big time. In the browser area, we're gonna go for the Bungalow Basement 02H today. How come this one house has like a normal name? Well, normal, you know, air quotes. How come all the other houses are like 01H dirty? Bungalow Basement 02H. And this one's like House Legend Admin. We need to get to this house, but we're gonna do this one first. The Bungalow Basement will be our next thing to make tons of money, and money is being made. Is that a pizza box? There's pizza in the game now? That's amazing. The outside of the house doesn't look terrible. Is that graffiti? What is this? Is it like some sort of gangster house? Oh, there's a lot of new textures here that aren't normally here. Look at this. We got plants going in the front. Hold on. This is like a legitimate full house makeover. Is there anything new and exciting we can do here? Like this gate or anything like that? There is trash way out here. Holy crap. There's like trash in the middle of the yard. Hold on, let me do a real quick 360 around here on the outside perimeter of this house. We have some lovely, what kind of trees are those, people? Some lovely wood trees out here on the outside. There is a lot of graffiti in this house. Hold on, I think we may have bought some gang members establishment or something. I mean, all the other houses in this neighborhood are very, very nice. This is not the kind of neighborhood where a house would be getting tagged regularly. This doesn't make any sense. Look at this place. Look at that house at the end. Holy crap. I would have flipped that house. There's some really nice houses here on this street. Okay. Enough of me gawking at all the houses that aren't ours. We have to pick up all the bottles of Skol Vodka laying all over the freaking walkway here. I'm not gonna lie, it feels like some sort of flop house or something. Let's go inside before we deal with the rest of this crap. All right, some normal trash on the mother of- Oh, no! Oh, my God. It was like a friggin' frat party massacre in here. Look at this. It's just pizza boxes, cheap booze. What else is going on in this? There is cheap beer bottle. It looks like friggin' Mountain Dew cans. Is that Mountain Dew or is it beer? I think it's just, it is, it's just beer. Like it legitimately just says beer across it. It is like the asset beer that you can get for Unity or whatever, I don't even know. Well, let's grab all, we got Mario's Pizza over here. Grab his stuff as well. Oh my God, the Mop of Redemption is gonna have a freaking field day in this place. The kitchen looks pretty nice. Like, the appliances are very good. I'm like, the house looks like the, you know, the house looks beat, but it doesn't look like the other house. If you remember the other house, the walls were cracking and the paper was peeling and the brick was showing and everything. This isn't like that. This house looks a lot. Now, don't get me wrong. It looks like someone was waltzing around in their own fecal material. But the fact that there's... Can I open and close this? Ooh. There we go. It was kind of like half open and annoying, but I'm glad I could close it all the way. But this here just looks like someone messed it up. It looks like it was... It's still a good house is what I mean. We can make this house look friggin' sweet, no doubt. I have a feeling that we got this house in a police auction. I think that this was a drug dealer's house. I think the developers are Russian... So, can anyone tell me if this stuff means anything? Like, to me, that just looks like a bowling ball. Or maybe a ghost. But, like, it's possible that some of this stuff is words. It could also just be, like, nameless crap. But I'm pretty sure... Well, no, hold on. I take that back. I think that the developers may be Polish. So, if we have any Russian or Polish... speaking people in the audience, maybe you can let me know if any of this graffiti means anything. Oh my God, each one of these cans are individual cans. This is driving me nuts. I think I liked it better when all the items were like one big texture. Like you would click on one thing and it would clean up like, there's pieces of pizza floating through the floor. Ah, the pizza's glitching through the floor. It's a whole pizza. They didn't even eat it. It was a whole pizza. Like one slice was taken out. It is. This is legitimately like a drug raid. They didn't even finish their pizza. They were in the middle of eating and the police burst, probably knocked the freaking door down, took everyone to jail. Our guy comes in with HDTV and is like, what do you guys want for it? And the police are like, ah, whatever, just the cost of the SWAT team stuff. So now we've got the one drug house in the middle of the million-dollar neighborhood that we're gonna have to renovate. Okay, all the trash is... I was gonna say, all the trash is done in here. There's like one piece over here, but like, I can't get it. It won't... A lot of times if you move the sofa, like if I move this, I can probably get it. There we go. I'll bet I can get it now. Oh, there's stuff behind the sofas too. No. Let's go into this room. More pizza boxes. More pizza boxes and Canada dry beer over here. It's what it feels like. Oh my, there's pizza boxes. It's like the only two things that the people in this house did were drink beer and eat pizza. That's... Actually, that sounds pretty legitimate for a lot of people. What's the rest of the... What the hell? Hold on. Okay, are you guys seeing... Is there a light switch on this door? Like, you guys talk about my decoration sense? I don't think that's the thing. Nope, it's levitating. There's a levitating switch on the door. Never thought I'd see the day. I don't know if we can get rid of that. Oh, the bathroom doesn't look that bad. I mean, again, it looks like an eruption of anal sewage sprayed itself all over the walls, the toilet, the sink, and the floor. But the bathroom looks fantastic. Like, oh man, this house is mostly put together. We're gonna have, this is gonna be easy money. Down into the basement, what should we find? A dead body, perhaps? Nope. Thank God. A couple of boxes. And a very nice space for, we could put a couple of things down here. We could very easily put our washer and dryer down here. A lot of storage down here too, which I'm pretty happy about. All right. And I think that's the entirety of the house. Right off the bat, let me think about this for a second. I feel like I want to get rid of a wall here. Like, I'm going to keep that like that. I was thinking about busting this whole wall down, but I do like this little bit of separation into the kitchen and then the living area. Graffiti busting mop of power, go! Yes, doesn't matter if it's paint. Doesn't matter if it's fabric. It doesn't matter if it's wood or brick. This thing will clean everything. Did that say ass?
Did that say ass?
That looked like the word I just cleaned off there said ass. I'm pretty sure it did. Hold on. I don't know if we're ever going to see it again. I would imagine that a lot of the graffiti is reused. Like, yeah, see? This piece here, okay? And then this piece here for sure. And there's more as well. Like that there, the mop-zo, and then we got mop-zo over here as well.
The vicious members of the mop-zo gang were once denizens of this glorious house in the middle of suburbia. Until one day, their law-breaking exploits were discovered by their neighbors, and they were subsequently flashbanged into the next century. And now, Gray Still Makes Money Incorporated has purchased the plot of land and looks to bring peace and civilization back to this neighborhood while his cat sadly yells at the door in the background. Well, this room looks legit. Good. Okay. Well, let's move into the bedroom over here. Is there anything else that we need to do in here? Oh, this place is gonna clean up real nice. This place is gonna clean up real nice. It doesn't even require that much of a touch-up. We are gonna wanna make this our own, clearly. But still, there's not that much that we need to do. Like, normally a lot of my time would... What the hell? Oh, there's a lot of random stains over here. It's like... You guys ever seen The Ring? Or The Grudge? It's like that, only in every single house. It's like the Ring Girl has infiltrated the tile and brick of every single house and has brought her watermarked death stains to every single residence that we have to deal with. Gotta clean up the outside of the house right over here. All the various graffitis and tags and all there have you gotta go.
You gotta save the bathroom for last, man. If I'm gonna die of sepsis or whatever, we might as well get most of the house done over here. Maybe my relatives, whoever I will all this stuff to, could finish cleaning up the house and sell it for a pretty penny. All right, we've got everything. There's a light switch around here somewhere that needs help, I think. Maybe that's what it is, or is it this toilet? Does it want us to reinstall this toilet? It's probably this toilet. Hold on. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Hold on, I gotta get this off here right now. Over to the bathroom area. Now, the last time, we bought this toilet, but today I want to buy this toilet. Let's check this one out over here. Oh, it doesn't like this one? Is it not good enough? All right. So you would think that we can't install this toilet, but don't you worry. Gray still breaks games. Watch this. Boom! Right there! As long as I turned it to the side, we were able to get that split second where I can put this thing in. You see that? That's my discovery skills at work right there. I saw someone said like I missed an outlet or something. I'll miss outlets, but I won't miss little opportunities like that to fix things up. Now, how about this over here? Can we change this at all? Like, is there a mounting area back here? It doesn't look like there is. There's not a mounting area back here. Take out that old bath and put in a nice new hot tub. Look at how legitimate that looks. Oh, this place is already looking fantastic. We do need to get rid of this insanity. I want to paint this bathroom. Someone in the comment section said a good color for a bathroom is brown and yellow, and you don't even need to paint it. That's horrifying. We're going to go ahead and paint it. I don't know if I want brown and yellow. You know what? We'll do it in brown and yellow. You want it brown and yellow? You're going to get brown and yellow. In fact, I think we'll do it like an accent wall. I think this wall is going to be our crazy accent wall, right? I want the yellow to contrast with this dark, rich, cherry-colored door. So let's do our accent wall over here, right here. I think that one's going to be it. So this wall will still be yellow. Oh, yeah. There you go. There's your bathroom. You know what? Oh, crap. I'm like stuck in a light or something over here. I'm stuck inside the toilet. How did this happen? Oh, crap. Yeah, you know what? I wanted to change this light anyway. Screw you. Screw you, light. There we go. Yeah, I wanted to get rid of that light anyway. Let me go ahead and get rid of these because they're really getting in the way. And, oh, that's right. We have CO2 detectors or, you know, fire detectors, whatever they are now. Let's go ahead and put something different up here. All right, we're putting this thing together. And speaking of fecal material, it's time for another story time with Gray, where I will tell you a tale of sadness and regret, the likes of which you have never known. So, one of the things that we have purchased a long time ago in my house, and we've had it for a while, and I'm very happy with it for the most part, is a robotic vacuum cleaner. I gotta tell you, our robotic vacuum cleaner always has a different name. We name our vacuum cleaner all the time. I think it's like Natasha or something right now. I don't remember. But nope, it's something else. My wife's giving me the thumbs down. I don't remember what it is, but it's something like that. It was Anastasia back in the day, and then it became something else, and it keeps kind of going. But it normally does a fantastic job. While she's away and I'm busy or whatever, it will vacuum the house, and I have horrible allergies, and it makes me feel good and alive in this world, and it's fantastic. Well, one day, it got a hold of something horrifying, and it was, you need to understand, it's very horrifying. I was out, and I came home, and I smelled a scent that was very, very familiar to me. It was the scent of cat crap, except the scent had been maneuvered all over the entire house. That was because one of my cats had, for whatever reason, I don't know why, the litter box is a fine place, maybe they were just pissed off at me, had crapped on the ground, like liquid style. And the robotic vacuum cleaner had moved it all over the entire house. And thus, all of the carpeting had to be pressure cleaned.
and all of the tiles had to be steam cleaned. We still use the robotic vacuum, but I always like leave the house with a little bit of anticipation now whenever I know it's gonna go off and I'm not around. Have any of you folks ever had something mechanical or robotic fail you in such a dramatic fashion? Just like I got to read a bunch of your other stories of sadness and regret. Feel free to let me know in the comments section. Strong orange. What a flavor. We're painting this hallway strong orange. I've never heard of such a thing. Straight from Home Depot, baby. Strong orange. The foyer over here, whatever this is. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's like, it's almost like a red. It's so strong, it's basically red. This is lovely. Hold on, let me go ahead and maneuver a little bit more stuff over on the fantastic painting widgetry we have now. I don't know how this thing works. It, like, you just have to tap your wall and the rest of it is magically painted as long as you can continue to flail your arms wildly. It is my kind of painter. All right, this light sucks. I'm getting rid of that one. We're gonna grab this chandelier. Japanese elm. Okay. Oh, that's a lot lighter than I thought it would be. Red cedar. Oh, it's really not that much darker. Okume. There we go. That's the level of darkness I like on my wood. Yes. Oh, that is glorious. Hold on, let me remove this bullcrap too. I want two of them in here. Wait, should we have two of them? That feels like too much. I don't think that we should have two of them. If anything, I mean, like maybe another lamp or something. But is that in the middle? It doesn't look like it's in the middle. Hold on here. There we go. Now it's in the middle. Okay, we're set. Next room. The living room and the kitchen. This kitchen, what do I want to do with this? Because like I said, the kitchen looks pretty good. I think I'd like to get a more potent refrigerator for sure and maybe a little bit more storage space. I really like the black countertop and like this colorful cabinetry over here. I like that. That looks pretty cool. Hold on, let's get rid of this though. Now this is a refrigerator. Oh yeah. Hold on. Is this so big that it doesn't even really fit in here? Hold on. Let me see if I can get it right up against the wall. Right? It sticks out a little bit. How do I feel about that? Oh, it's so glorious, though. Look at it. LG, everyone. This channel is not sponsored by LG. They make fantastic stuff, but they have no idea that I'm even a part of YouTube. Yeah. I feel like it could use a little bit more spacing. I wanted to do something special. I can't. There's just not enough space. Like, the door on the double side refrigerator would be opening right into this. I think this one opens this way? I don't know what way this thing opens. I think that's the same one that was there previously. Oh yeah, look at this. They don't really match color-wise. I tried to find something that completely matched sofa and armchair. They're there, but we'd have to use like the same ones that we've been using for quite some time. I didn't really want to do that. As a matter of fact, hold on. I think I want to try like the different sofas and stuff like that. In fact, I may move this. Hold on. Over there. This way we can move this over here. I'd like a little breakfast nook if we can get one over in the kitchen. I'm pretty sure we can get a breakfast nook going on. Pick up this coffee. And you know what? Let's get a different, maybe we can get a different coffee table as well. There's not a lot of coffee tables that are very big. Like, there's only a couple that are of a large size. Like, this one over here is fine. It's just not very large. Let's go ahead and put that there. Then move this one, like, a little bit. Right like that, maybe. Is there enough space? There kind of is. Like, it's weird because I don't actually know how big I am in the grand scheme of things. We have a height, but we never really get to see, you know, our legs or anything. It's probably big enough. We need some TVs up in here. I remember there was one thing it said like, I want TVs in all my saloons or something like that. All right, there we go. There's your TVs right over there. So you can be not lonely all the time. You can be on your social not lonely, your news not lonely, your music not lonely, the TV, the video, the YouTube,
All that kind of stuff. There you go. Not lonely for days. We need some more stuff in here, though. I want, like, I still want, like, a little breakfast nook area. See some cans down here, too. Gotta get rid of those. All right, get a nice little dining experience over here. One of those. This one like this. There we go. Now I just need something for this little filler area. I feel like we need, like, a piece of tall art. I just don't think that we have enough of that stuff. Laundry basket, safe. No, nothing like that. There we go. Yes. Now we're looking legit. We even got our bunny over here. Our bunny buddy hanging around doing their thing. Do I want something like in this corner over here, I wonder? I almost feel like I want something like right over here in this corner. This bookcase matches that pretty good, I think. Yeah. Yeah, I think it matches it pretty well, actually. All right. Now, if only I could get the books to go like long ways. That's the only problem. I can never seem to get the books facing that direction. I don't think it's possible. See how they lay down like this? If I hold my rotational thing, they do that. It's not what I want, though. You can't stack the books either. So I'm essentially just like buying a bunch of random books and throwing them heedlessly all over this bookshelf. Those secrets. I love some of these names. What's it say? Oh, deep psychology. I thought it said like deep thaumaturgy or something like that. Over to the bedroom where dreams come true. One different bed. Let's see over here. What do we have? You know what? We can do Chang Choi is always one of our big buyers. So maybe all he wants is a nice single bed with a drawer. That one looks okay. Let's see what else we got. I know someone said this is a loft bed. I know. I'm just calling it by whatever the game calls it. The game happens to call it a bunk bed with desk. So that's how I do. What other single beds? Oh, that one looks pretty cool. We could do that one over there. Classic double bed sweetness. I actually have to buy this. I can't not buy this. Yellow, uh-huh. Okay. Little flowers. Gold flowers, that's kind of like yellow. Pink crate, sure. Ornament. Beach. What is this? What does this monstrosity look like? It's everything I hoped for. Oh, the love doctor's in. Hold on, let me get rid of this. We gotta put this thing down. Oh, it's majestic. Oh, it's so good. Hold on, let me, this. There we go. Right up against the wall. Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, Chang Choi. When you have your lady friends over, they will be absolutely smitten with the freaking bed linen choices that I have made for you. All right, we've got a different wardrobe over here that fits the bill much better. There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, glory upon glory. So, let's turn on the lights in here. Can I turn on the lights? Oh. That's odd. We have these little light fixtures up here. Maybe if I put a different style of lighting up? There we go. That's a lovely lamp right over there. The soft golden glow can stream down upon Chang Choi and his mate of choice. Now all we need is a lovely color for the inside of this room. I do like this as an accent wall. But I think I want to change things around a little bit. Ah, yes. The color of love and blood and fire, but potentially love. I'm going to stack this room with this crap over here. It's going to be friggin' great. And then from there, we'll figure something nice and light to do with the last wall. There we go. Oh, this is something special. It's like Cupid threw up in here. It's perfect. Okay. Now there's one last thing for us to do, and that is the basement. Oh, I think you could paint all of the basement now. Remember how originally you could only paint so high on the basement walls? Now it's looking like I can paint them all. Oh yeah, there we go. This basement, we're really gonna open this place up. There we have, fantastic, lovely, excellent. Using this whole bucket of paint too, man. This takes a lot of paint to do all this. Alright, that's kind of a washer-dryer setup. They don't really have- they have like a mountable washer, but I don't have a place to mount it. That's the only problem. Alright, I think we've made something very special here. Very special. Hold on, there's one other thing I definitely want to do. I want to see if this increases our value at all. While you're washing and drying, let's go ahead and give you a TV right up over there. What's that? You just walked into the house? How about you check out this lovely TV over here? While you're cooking over here in the kitchen, I think you'd like to have something to watch on TV. Over here in the bedroom, Chang Choi, you're gonna want to be watching something with your love interest, and thus, I have this glorious TV for you. Oh, can I put it above the doorway? Ha ha ha! Perfect! Okay, we're freaking set. This is gonna be a moneymaker right here. I can already feel it. Let us go to auction and see what sort of cash we can make with this glorious beauty. Begin the auction. The floors are so empty. You shut your mouth, Jantart. No one loves you. Okay, Jack Tarrington has something to say. Jimmy Trader says, this is it, dude. The amount of bathrooms is acceptable. Okay. Oh, here it is, Chang Choi. Oh! Chang Choi! $300,000 for the sale! What amount of books? Holy crap! Okay, hold on. Green walls are helping people to focus? Whatever, I don't, that doesn't, whatever. Look at this! We made a profit of $165,000! Oh, wow! We are almost at $500,000, and for the first freaking time, this game has paid us out substantially. Guys, hope you're enjoying House Flipper. Until the next time, stay foxy and much love.